So today we are going to see history of plant pathology or timeline into the plant pathology. What are the contributions and what are the achievements which happens into the plant pathology? Okay, myself NH Shankar Reddy. I am doing a PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. First year PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. So here the history of plant pathology is mainly divided into the five main eras. So coming to the past to present, ancient era, dark era, pre-modern era, modern era, and present era. So the ancient era, which was in ancient times from the 5th century, whereas the dark era timeline between the 5th and 16th century, and the pre-modern era 17th century to 1853. So modern era 1815 to 1900, and as well as present era 1900 onwards. So coming to the ancient era, a few of the achievements and the archives which happens in India, what are they? If you look into Rigveda, Atharveda, Arthashastra, which was written by Kautilya, Shushruta Samhita, Vishnu Purana, Agni Purana, and a few of the books which was written by the people or whatever we can say, philosophers which were there in those times. So they mentioned a few of the plant diseases and their management practices. Of course, this indicates that the plant diseases are not a new to us, so it's already existed from the past time, which was from olden time onwards. So if you see one by one, the first one is Theophrastus. So Theophrastus is considered as the father of botany, because in olden times all the plant diseases or genetics or whatever the things which was mostly dealt by the people of botany. So nowadays we have our plant pathology, genetics and all those things, but olden days they don't have any such type of subject. So whatever the plant related things which was dealt by botanists only. So Theophrastus is considered as father of botany, and he wrote two books which was inquiry into the plants and the nature of plants and the reasons of vegetable growth. Of course, these two books contains few of the plant diseases and then management practices. Of course, he told that plant diseases are the worth or punishments of gods, those who committed wrong things. Let us consider, if the farmer is committed a wrong thing, his field is infected with different types of diseases. They strongly believe in those times the plant diseases are worse or punishment of God, those who committed the wrong things. So that is, of course, there's a best indication that at least they don't committed any wrong things or sins. So the next one is the Democritus. So he recommended that plant blights can be controlled by the sprinkling of olive oil. So plant blights can be controlled by the sprinkling of olive oil. The next one is Homer. He mentioned that therapeutic properties of sulfur. It is the oldest fungicide or plant disease controlling fungicide or whatever. So sulfur is the oldest one that was recommended by the Homer in 1000. The next one is Robigolia. So Robigolia is actually a festival which was actually celebrated by the Romans, European people, especially Romans. So they praise the god or they worship the god to prevent the destruction of their crops. So actually in olden days they thought that wheat stem rust is mainly due to the god, because I already told you that those who committed wrong things, they will get affected with the rust. In those, they are strongly believe in the this theme. Olden days. So it was actually initiated by King Numa Pompilius. According to the Christian calendar, in every year April 25th is considered as Robigolia. You know, on this occasion of Robigolia, the Romans usually used to sacrifice a few of the animals like oxes, foxes, and goats. So many things they usually used to sacrifice. They worship the god to not give the rust to us, because rust is a very destructive disease in olden days, from olden days itself. So on the time itself, the people strongly believe to start that spontaneous generation theory. So of course, even though it's wrong, in olden days they strongly believe that it's a spontaneous generation theory. Also the next one is Albertus Magnus. He's not a scientist, but actually he's a priest. On the right side, we can see the diagrammatic representation of Albertus Magnus. So he was the first priest to recognize the plant disease, that is mistletoe or giant mistletoe. Giant mistletoe is the first recognized plant pathogen in the world, and he recommended that cultural practices like pruning is the best management practices for the control of giant mistletoe or mistletoes. So the next one is the Nicander. He called the mushroom as the evil fermenters of the earth. And the next one is ergotism, which was first reported by Taulier in 1670. He is a French physician. On the left side, we can see the wheat grains which are infected with ergot. and the black color discoloration we can see, that's a sclerotia. So on the right side, the man who injected, or sorry, who had the infected grains of this ergot, they had the symptoms. They can see in hands, holy fire. That's why it's called as holy fire, because the firing symptoms can be seen on the infected parts. We can see the hands, the holy firing symptoms can be seen. That's why it's called as holy fire. So in those times, they actually thought that was mainly due to curse of God. So, but it was mainly due to the infected ingestion of infected grains. In those times, the poor people only have a bread. So the bread was prepared from the infected grains. If the bread was consumed by the humans, of course they got ergotism. So in French, ergot means spur, which was ergotism is mainly due to the fungus Claviceps purpurea. So the symptoms in humans can be seen: reddening and blistering, the pain in abdomen, muscle spasms, trembling, shaking, and the firing symptoms can be seen. Already told you that it has different names: Devil's Curse, Fire, Holy Fire, and Saint Anthony's Fire. Why it is called as Saint Anthony's Fire? Because the order of saints, which they were constructed so many hospitals to help the ergot infected people. So this ergot alkaloid, mainly due to the ergot infected grains, contain an ergot alkaloid called LSD. It is called as lysergic acid diethyl amide. It is also considered as drug of the century, which is mainly used to cure mental patients or mental problems. So due to the presence of this alkaloid, it is mainly act as a hallucinogen. Hallucinogen, of course, hope all will know about what is hallucinogen. Next one is the Clusius. The water drawings of mushrooms can be done by Clusius. And of course, he wrote a book called Rerorium Plantarum Historica that is completely devoted to plant disease as well as different types of things, of plant related things. So next one is Robert Hooke. Robert Hooke is the first man to see the cells, or to observe the cells from the plant tissues. So he called the units as cells. So of course, he wrote a book called Micrographia, which was released in 1665, and he drawn the sporangia of mucor and the teleospores from Phragmedium discophorum, the Phragmedium micronatum, and that was first observed in a microscope. The next one is Carolus van Linnaeus. So he induced the binomial system of nomenclature, which means every organism which has two names, one is the genus name, the next one is the species name, that is called the binomial nomenclature. And he published the greatest work, that is the Systema Nature, and then very important thing is the Species Plantarum, which is mentioned so many types of plant species and how to name the species and the binomial systems, which was released in 1753. Of course, he has two students, C.H. Persoon and E.M. Fries, which later become great contributors to the plant pathology. On the right side, we can see the diagrammatic representation of Carolus van Linnaeus and the book written by Carolus van Linnaeus, that is Species Plantarum, on the right side we can see here. And the next one is P.A. Michelli, is an Italian scientist. So for every slide on the right side, the diagrammatic representation of the particular contribution or maybe the scientist can be there on the right side. So hope you find that. And he is considered as the father of mycology. Father of mycology. So mycology, which mainly deals with the study of fungi. So he is considered as father of mycology. He wrote a book which is the greatest contribution, that is Nova Plantarum Genera, which mentioned different types of plant species, and all those things can be mentioned in Nova Plantarum Genera. And he proved that first diseases was called by spores. So fungi produce spores. So he first to report that disease was caused by spores, and almost described the different types of 900 types of fungi. Next one is C.H. Persoon. Already told you, is a student of Carolus van Linnaeus. He is considered as founding father of systemic mycology, and also called as founding father of modern taxonomy of mushrooms. So he published so many articles, and as well as also involved in the contribution of systemic classification. And his great contribution is the publication of Synopsis Methodica Fungorum, which is a very chief starting point for the naming of fungi. Actually, due to his poverty, he sold his entire herbarium to the Dutch government in 1825 due to his poverty. We can see the scientist's situation in those days. And the next one is Charles Darwin, of course, Origin of Species, which was the greatest contribution from the Charles Darwin. he wrote a book, published a book called Origin of Species by Means of Natural Selection. Though coming to E.M. Fries is also a student of Carolus von Linnaeus. He is considered as Linnaeus of mycology or father of systemic mycology. So coming to his contribution, he wrote a book called System of Mycologism, which was published in 1821, which is the starting point of nomenclature of fungi as well as E.F.C. Pashun. And he is regarded as rust and smut fungi as a product of disease plants. So rust and smut is mainly comes to disease plants according to him. So Basidium mycota is entirely dominated by Friesian approach, which was given by Fries. Though coming to the Matthew D. Tillett, so he is considered as a great grandfather of phytopathology because he mostly worked on wheat bunt diseases, and it was usually considered as contagious diseases in those days. So he is considered as great grandfather of phytopathology. Coming to the Toulsaint brothers, L.R. Toulsaint is considered as reconstructor of mycology. What are the diagrammatic life cycle that we are studying today, which was everything was drawn or lighted by Charles Toulsaint, L.R. Toulsaint. So they published a book called Selecta Fungorum Carpologica, which was published in between 1861 and 1865. So the next one is J.G. Kuhn. He's a German scientist. First book completely devoted, he published the first book that is completely devoted to plant pathology. Before that, we have seen so many books that they're not completely devoted to plant pathology. Mostly they have mentioned that classification of plant species or the nomenclature of plant species. But this is the first book that is completely devoted to plant pathology or completely devoted to the plant diseases and their management practices. Coming to the book name is The Diseases of Cultivated Crops, Their Causes and Their Control, which was published in 1858. He is also considered as a microscopic era. Modern era starts with the great Anton de Bary. Heinrich Anton de Bary is a German scientist. He is a German surgeon, botanist, microbiologist and mycologist. So he is largely considered as father of plant pathology. Father of modern plant pathology. Father and founder of modern experimental plant pathology. He is largely considered because he has the greatest contribution and great contributions in plant pathology. He discovered the life cycle of late blight of potato. Late blight of potato, we all will know that late blight of potato is the main reason for the initiation of a new subject or new branch that is called plant pathology. So he discovered the late blight of potato life cycle that is caused by Phytophthora infestans. So he wrote a book called Comparative Morphology and the Biology of Fungi, Mycetes and Bacteria. Actually, it is a German version, which was English translated by Beflor in 1887. Actually, this book was first released in 1866, a German version which was released in 1866, but the English version which was translated in the year of 1887. So, of course, he has some publications and lectures on bacteria, on milieu fermentations, comparative anatomy and vegetative growth. So many things he was published. As I told that English translation, which was done in 1887, authored by E.F. Gerson and Beflor. So, Anton de Bary introduced the terms Astoria, otherwise called as Syncus, Symbiosis, Teletospores, Mycetosa, Sex Hormones, of course the first sex hormone which was discovered by Siren and Anthradiol by Anton de Bary, and Autoecious and Heterocious nature of rust also can be explained by Anton de Bary, and the Chlamydospores are coined by Anton de Bary. Of course, students are M.S. Voronin, Oscar Brefield, Millardart, H.M. Watt, Farlow, Fisher. These students later become the greatest contributors or the fathers in the particular field. So, due to this, he became the greatest scientist. That's why Anton de Bary is considered as father of plant pathology due to his greatest contributions towards the plant pathology. So, of course, Sclerotinia sclerosum was identified by Anton de Bary. Of course, Phytophthora, the name Phytophthora, which was given by Anton de Bary, which means phyto means plant, thora means destroyer. Phytophthora means it's a plant destroyer. On the right side, we can see the Astoria, Teleospores, Symbiosis, and the diagrammatic grip. The next one is M.S. Voronin. As already told, that he is a student of Anton de Bary. He discovered the life cycle of club root of cabbage and named the pathogen is a Plasmodiophorae brassicae in 1875. So, and also potato wart, that is called by Cinchidrium endobioticum life cycle, also discovered by M.S. Voronin. He also discovered the Voronin boils. And then H.M. Watt is also a student of Anton de Bary. is considered as father of tropical plant pathology. Father of tropical plant pathology. Of course, he mainly deals with the diseases related to the tropical areas and all those things. And he emphasizes that epidemiology, that is environmental conditions, will play a major role in coffee rust. And this theory was which was formulated by H.M. Ward in 1903. So next one is P.M.A. Milladet. So he's also a student of Anton DeBerry. He discovered Bordeaux mixture for the control of grapes downy mildew. In those times in French, French related areas are the huge contributors for the production of grapes. So they mainly used for the production of wine. Wine industries are huge in French. So he discovered the Bordeaux mixture for the control of grapes downy mildew. It is considered as serendipity discovery. So he discovered accidental, that is why called a serendipity discovery. So coming to the composition of Bordeaux mixture, it is 1:1:100. So 1 kilogram of copper sulfate, 1 kilogram of hydrated lime, 100 liters of water contributes to Bordeaux mixture. So Bordeaux mixture can be applied for almost all crops except few. That is Bordeaux mixture shy crops. We can call it as Bordeaux mixture shy crops. Best example, Rosaceae family, apple. Few of the crops we can't mention Bordeaux mixture, and Bordeaux mixture can't apply during rainy season. Except that we can apply Bordeaux mixture for all crops. So for all fungicide we can use at the rate of 0.1% concentration, except Bordeaux mixture, where the Bordeaux mixture can be used at the rate of 1% concentration. Here actually the original formula developed by Bordeaux mixture is 5 lbs of copper sulfate and 5 lbs of lime and 50 gallons of water. I think 1 gallon contributes almost 3.3 or 4 liters of water. So almost it sets with the equal volumes, whereas we can see that 1:1:100. So that's why for easy understanding we can convert it into like this 1:1:100. So the next one is Bordax, where Bordeaux mixture in the Bordax, which was the university name in France where Milladet has worked. So Bordax is the university name. Don't think that Bordax is the the surname or whatever. So Bordax is the university name where Milladet works. That's why to honor the university he named it as Bordeaux mixture. So Erickson described the phenomenon of physiological specialization in a wheat stem rust, that is the Fuchsinia graministridis. So regarding in detail about physiological specialization, we can see in the later classes. Okay. So the next one is P.A. Secado, Italian scientist. He is a professor at Padua University. Coming to the greatest scientific contribution to the plant pathology is a famous book, that is Psyllium Fungorum, which comprises of almost 26 volumes. It's a huge amount of books which was written by P.A. Secado. So almost 20, actually it was originally 26 volumes of work, which in published in between 1882 to 1931. So the full name of Psyllium Fungorum is Psyllium Fungorum Omnium Ascom Cognitorum. It is the full name of Psyllium Fungorum. So Secado is of course one of the great other contributions also there, that is Fungi Italic, which was appeared in 38 volumes of work, which are published in between 1877 and 1886. So next one is J.F. Daster. Is an Indian scientist, plant pathologist, internationally known as the establishment of the new genera, that is Phytophthora parasitica in India, which was caused the diseases in castor and potato. So is the first president of IPS, which is the Indian Phytopathological Society, IPS. And also the one who reported the first plant viral diseases in India, that is the sugarcane mosaic virus, which was reported by J.S. Dale. The scientist which was come from Ireland, so the first empirical mycologist in India, is considered as father of modern plant pathology in India, as well as father of Indian mycology. So the first director of empirical bureau of mycology in England from 1920s to 1930s, he hugely investigated different types of fungal diseases and fungi related things in India. So he wrote a great book called Fungi and Diseases in Plants, which was published in the year of 1918. And he also wrote a few of the monographs, that is Pithecias and Allied Fungi, the Fungi of India, along with Bisbee and Bisbee in 1931. And also published some of the publications and books on plant pathology with Sir S.G. Jones. And he discovered the new genus called Allomyces. And he was the first to report the first bacterial disease in India, that is Bengal blight of potato. It is the first recorded disease in India. And he appointed as the first cryptogamic botanist of in government of India at Calcutta. So coming to the E.C. Stockman, which was from USA, the first to coin the term hypersensitivity or autolysis. It was the greatest mechanism that plant possess. So to prevent the spread of a further infection, the plant cells die itself to prevent the spread of the disease. That is called a hypersensitive reaction, which was discovered by E.C. Stockman in 1915. The next one is J.H. Krayek. He discovered the sexual stage of rust fungus. It is called as Pycnia or Spamacea, also called as zero stage, because wheat stem rust life cycle has five stages. That is zero stage, Roman stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, stage 4. So here he discovered the zero stage, that is called as spermaceal stage or pycnial stage. The next one is Alexander Fleming. He isolated antibiotic penicillin from Penicillium notatum. Of course, now Penicillium notatum is called as Penicillium chrysogenum. And he shared the Nobel Prize for the discovery of penicillium along with Ernest B. Chain and Harvard Walter Florey in 1945. So next one is J.C. Walker. So he was the first to demonstrate the chemical nature of disease resistance in plants. So he identified the two substances, that is catechol and protocatechic acid, which are resistance against onion smudge. So these two phenolic substances which are present in red onion, that's why red onion is resistant to onion smudge than white onion, because white onion doesn't contain any phenolic compounds like catechol and protocatechol. So here Walker developed the most of the developed resistance varieties on onion, cabbage, beans, peas, beetroots and cucumbers. So the next one is K.C. Mehta. He's an Indian scientist. He's also considered the father of Indian rust. And he discovered the life cycle of a wheat stem rust and reported that barberry act as an alternate host in a wheat stem rust. And he published the two monographs. There are further studies on cereal rust, part 1, which was released in 1940. And second one is part 2 in 1952. So next one is Muller and Borger. So the term phytoalexin was coined by Muller and Borger, and the concept of phytoalexins, which was enacted by Muller and Borger. So the phyto means plant, alexin means protecting substance. Very simple, phytoalexins are the plant protecting substances which are produced by the plants against pathogenic infections. So the first phytoalexin discovered by Pisatin, which was produced from pea plant, Pisum sativum. So the molecular formula has been mentioned, C17H1406. So next one is Paul Nierengard, is a Denmark scientist, which is considered as father of seed pathology. And along with Mary Noble, he coined the term seed pathology. So Paul Nierengard is considered as father of seed pathology. And he published a book called Seed Pathology, which comprises of two volumes, which was released in 1977. So the next one is H.H. Flower, gave gene for gene concept or gene for gene hypothesis on plant pathogen genetic interaction while working with linseed rust, that is Melonsorolini or flax, linseed otherwise called as flaxseed. So here he also proposed the term avirulence gene. So what gene for gene hypothesis explains, for every virulence gene in the host, there must be a corresponding avirulence gene in the pathogen. Very simple, whatever the genes that is produced by the pathogen, there is a corresponding virulence gene in the, whatever the virulence gene produced by the plant, there is a corresponding virulence gene in the pathogen. That's why this is occurs, yes? Pathology. So the next one is the Ponte Corvo and Roper. So they discovered parasexuality in Aspergillus nidalens. So very simple, parasexuality. On the right side, we can see on the upper side, Ponte Corvo, on the lower side, Roper. So as parasexuality was discovered in organism, Aspergillus nidalens in the year of 1952. What is parasexuality? Is coming to the parasexuality. Plasmogamy, karyogamy and meiosis not occurs in a regular stage or regular manner. That's why it is called as parasexuality. Here parasexuality can get the benefits of sexual reproduction, but here the sexual reproduction is not involved. So parasexuality type of reproduction can be mainly seen in Deuteromycota group of fungi. Now Deuteromycota is involved in Squamycota, of course. Though the next one is Van der Planck. So he is considered as father of plant disease epidemiology. And he has a great contribution towards epidemiology. That's why he became a father in plant disease epidemiology. He gave the concept of vertical and horizontal resistance and also called the term vertifolia effect to describe the horizontal resistance. So coming to what is vertifolia effect, very simple, loss of horizontal resistance while breeding for vertical resistance. So this can be observed in the German potato varieties. So he published 5 major books. We can see the important one, that is a Plant Disease Epidemics and Control, which was a very very important book, which was written by J.E. Van der Planck in 1963. And the other books which include Disease Resistance in Plants, Principles of Plant Infection, Genetics and Molecular Basis of Plant Pathogens, Host Pathogen Interaction, Plant Disease, was published in 68, 75, 78 and 82. So coming to N.E. Borlaug, Norman E. Borlaug. He is considered as father of Green Revolution because he initiated the Green Revolution in 1950s and 1960s in European Eastern countries. So where that was initiated by, where it was initiated in India in 1965 and 1966 by M.S. Swaminathan. So due to the initiation of Green Revolution in producing sustainable, producing a huge amount of food crops, he got the Nobel Peace Prize in 1970s. For his contribution, great contribution towards the food supply, increasing the food supply. So he was actually an agronomist, but he obtained plant pathology and genetics in PhD. So next one is M.J. Tirumalachur on the right side, and on the right side we can see the Tirumalachur picture. So he was very famous in developing the antifungal antibiotic, that is Areofungin. Very very important. This was Areofungin is an antifungal antibiotic which was developed by M.J. Tirumalachur, and also developed the hyamycin, dermostatin, MYC4 and tertinium. These are the antibiotics which were developed by Tirumalachur, and also published a books. He also published a book that is Antibiotics in Plant Disease Controls. And he also wrote a monograph on Histolagnales in India, Eridanales of the World, Cercospora, Pisoderma, and Cephalosporium. So these are the monographs which was written by M.J. Tirumalachur. The next one is Jacob Cotton. He is an Israeli scientist. So he is considered as father of soil solarization. So this is the soil solarization is the technique especially recommended for the control or management of soil borne diseases. Especially we can see the damping of Pythium affine dermatum. He suggested that the polythene bag size is 100 micron. 100 micron is the suggested by Jacob Cotton. So next one is M.B. Dickman and Kolakkadi. So the isolated cutinase, the cell wall degrading enzyme which was responsible for the direct penetration of a pathogen. So by using this they developed a cutinase gene from Fusarium accessorium pharma specialized species PC which was cloned once. So next one is Klesig and Ruskin. So they demonstrated the cracking concept, that is salicylic acid is associated with the systemic acquired resistance. That is an inbuilt mechanism that is present in the plants. We already seen hypersensitive response. So all those things which was activated by systemic acquired resistance only. Then one is Broglie and Chen. So their plant transformed gene, that is a chitinase gene, which exhibits the enhanced resistance. So this chitinase gene exhibits the resistance against the disease which is caused by the fungi whose cell wall is contains chitin in their cell wall. Let us consider this gene is especially against a fungi whose cell wall contains chitin in their cell wall. So most of the fungi contains chitin as the cell wall, except the oomycota, where the cell wall is made up of cellulose. Accounts on mycology. Coming to the next one is bacteriology. Study of bacteria or plant related bacteria is called bacteriology. So the term bacteria was coined by Ehrenberg in 1838. The next one is Francesco Redi, Italian scientist. So he is considered as founder of experimental biology and father of modern parasitology. He was the first man to raise the hand against spontaneous generation theory, where the spontaneous generation theory explains the life originate from inanimate things. So here that is the last actual processor. So here he was the first to raise against spontaneous generation theory, and he told that maggots comes from eggs and flies. So and he wrote that experiments on generation of insects which was published in the year of 68. So coming to the Leeuwenhoek, developed the first microscope. Actually, first microscope was developed by Zacharias Janssen. So he developed the microscope magnification lenses. So magnification lenses were developed by Leeuwenhoek. So that's why he called as the father of bacteriology. He developed hundreds of microscopic magnifications, obtained the magnification range in between 500 to 300 diameter nanometer. So he also discovered the spermatozoa and red blood cells. He published the first publications in 1683. So after the discovery of the small bacteria, I told that, dear God, what marvels, they are so small a creature, said by Leeuwenhoek. So because they are very small, we can't able to see with the naked eye. That's why he was amazed with that. The next one is Louis Pasteur. He is considered as father of modern bacteriology and the founder of bacteriology. He was experimentally disproved that spontaneous generation theory and give a new concept that is called germ theory, because germ theory of diseases, which told that any disease, infectious, whatever the disease, is mainly due to the microorganisms, not by inanimate things. So, and of course also developed the vaccines against so many diseases like rabies, anthrax. So we can see the pasteurization. So pasteurization can be performed for alcoholic beverages and wine, beer, milk, so many things will be there. So coming to the very important pasteurization temperature for milk, we can see here, pasteurization temperature for milk is 62.8 degrees centigrade or 145.04 degree Fahrenheit. So it is important question, what is the pasteurization temperature for milk? So it is 62.8 degrees centigrade. The next one is Robert Koch. So the father of, is considered as father of modern bacteriological techniques. He is also considered as founder of modern bacteriology. He was first to discover the bacterium Bacillus anthracis, and he proposed the most remarkable concept, that is Koch postulates, which comprises of four postulates. So among the four postulates, three postulates was given by Robert Koch, and the fourth Koch postulate was given by E.F. Smith. So the next one is E.F. Smith. So he was the first that gave the final proof that bacteria could cause the plant diseases. Before that, T.J. Burrell, one more scientist, that is, I forgot to mention that. That is T.J. Burrell. He was the first to completely coming with a new idea that bacteria is responsible for plant diseases. So T.J. Burrell was first to discover the plant diseases in 1817, between 1882. So the first disease discovered by T.J. Burrell is fire blight of apple, that is caused by Yersinia amylovera, fire blight of apple. So T.J. Burrell is considered as father of bacteriology, founder of bacteriology. So he worked on, coming to the Smith, Smith worked on bacterial wilt of cucumber in between 1900s, so on crown gall in 1911. So that's why due to his contribution of almost 40 years of his life spent on working on bacterial disease and their management practices, so he's considered father of phytobacteriology or father of plant bacteriology. And he published a few of the books, that is Bacteria in Relation to Plant Diseases, which was published in the year of 1905, 1911 and 1914. Of course, there are some volumes, so which was published in between. So the next one is Introduction to Plant Bacterial Diseases in Plant, which was published in the year of 1920. And some other contribution like Nageli and S.C. Dillet. S.C. Dillet is the French retired army surgeon who coined the term microbe. So the term microbe was coined by S.C. Dillet. So I already told you that T.J. Burrell, founder of phytobacteriology, identified the first bacterial disease, that is Yersinia amylovera, which causes fire blight in apple and pear. On the right side, we can see the fire blight symptoms is the scientist T.J. Burrell who discovered the fire blight of apple. Next one is Christian Gram. He developed the bacterial staining technique. Staining means coloring. So while we color the bacteria, it will be very easy to understand their bacterial shape, flagella arrangement, internal structural arrangement. It will be very easy if we stain. So based on the staining, bacteria can be divided into gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria. So most of the bacteria comes under gram negative bacteria, except a few. So let me tell you a simple identification for gram positive bacteria. You are studying BSc agriculture, yes? So BSc, B stands for Bacillus, S stands for Streptomyces, C stands for Corynebacterium. Only these three or four bacteria comes under gram positive. So what are the gram positive bacteria? That is BSc, B stands for Bacillus, C stands for Clostridium, C stands for Corynebacterium. These are the bacteria comes under gram positive bacteria. Remaining almost all plant pathogenic bacteria are gram negative bacteria. So coming to next contributions, that is Twert and Herrili discovered the bacteriophage. Phage means eater, bacterial eater. It is a virus which attacks bacteria, so that's why it calls a bacteriophage, bacterial eater. So in 1923, Begge's Manual of Determinative Bacteriology published by David H. Berge, and then a few of the contributions like Mervyn Cotillard has been seen. So the next one is Waxman, one of the greatest contribution in history of bacteriology. He is considered as a father of soil microbiology as well as father of antibiotics. He is considered as father of antibiotic because he discovered the first broad spectrum antibiotic and as well first a broad spectrum antibiotic that is used for the management of plant diseases, that is streptomycin. So streptomycin, which was isolated from Streptomyces graecius in the year of 1943. So for the discovery of streptomycin, it awarded as a Nobel Prize in the physiology of medicine in the year of 1952. So coming to the next contribution, so Lederberger, Tatum, he discovered the bacterial conjugation, actually the sexual reproduction. So in sexual reproduction of bacteria, there are few of the things that can be seen, that is conjugation, transformation and transduction. So here Lederberger and Tatum, they discovered the bacterial conjugation in Escherichia coli. So the term plasmid was coined by Lederberger. Do you know one thing? Lederberger has just 20 years old while he discovered the concept of conjugation. Just 20 years old. Of course, Lederberger received the Nobel Prize in 1958 for the discovery, concerning the discovery related to the recombination or genetic exchange of genetic materials in bacteria. So then one is Staskovic cloned the first equivalent gene from bacteria, that is Pseudomonas syringae, Plethora glycinia. So the coming to the virology, so study of plant virus or plant related virus is called plant virology. So coming to the contributions, Adolf Meyer, he coined the term mosaic, and he thought that a mosaic disease of tobacco is caused by bacteria, because after performing the experiments in Chamberlain filter paper, even though the virus return, in fact in those time we don't know whether it was caused by bacteria or virus, but he thought that it was caused by bacteria. So he called that SAM transmission of tobacco disease as mosaic cancrate in German language. So the next one is Ivanovsky, is from Russia. So he proved that the causal agent of tobacco mosaic could pass through the bacterial proof filter. So it is not caused by bacteria. So he concluded that the causal agent of tobacco mosaic virus is smaller than bacteria. So he was the first to discover the inclusion bodies. So inclusion bodies is very simple. It's identification factors of the virus. So if he found inclusion bodies in plant cells or in plants, so which easily identified that the disease is mainly due to virus. So he described the horizontal transmission of plant viruses. So the next one is a great contributions coming to the Bijernik. So he's a Dutch microbiologist and botanist. He's hugely considered as father and founder of plant virology, and also considered as father of environmental ecology. The term virus was coined by M.J. Bijernik. He called that liquid material of virus is a contagium vivum fluidum. So this fluid is the main reason for the repeated infection of tobacco mosaic virus. So he also due to its remembrance, Clostridium bijernicki is a gram-positive rod-shaped bacterium which was named after Bijernicki. Twert and Herrilli, they are individually discovered bacteriophages, bacterial eaters. A virus which infect bacteria is called bacteriophages. The next one is Holmes. He developed the local lesion assay on Nicotiana glutinosa. So and viral hypersensitivity is also discovered by Holmes. So the next one is McKinney. So he developed a cross protection or pre-immunization technique for the control of Citrus tristeza virus. Actually, the cross protection technique was originally developed against tobacco mosaic virus, but is a best practice against Citrus tristeza virus. Very simple. What is cross protection means? Using of mild strains of plant virus to prevent the severe strains infection. The next one is Noll and Ruska, which discovered the electron microscope, or the first electron microscope which was discovered by Noll and Ruska in the year of 1931 between 1932. Of course, the first developed microscope capable of magnifying 400 range power. Then after 1933, Ruska built an electron microscope which is the most capable, almost magnifies 1 lakh to 10 lakh size in range. So for the discovery, for the fundamental work of electron opticals, Ruska got Nobel Prize in 1986. The next one is W.M. Stanley. So he was the first to purify or crystallize the tobacco mosaic virus. So purification and crystallization of tobacco mosaic virus was first done by W.M. Stanley by using a chemical called ammonium sulfate. So due to this work, he initiated the molecular plant pathology work. Due to the isolation or the purification of TMV, he initiated the molecular plant pathology work. So due to that, he received the Nobel Prize in 1946 for the crystallization or purification of tobacco mosaic virus. The next one is Bowden and Pyrie. So Bowden and Pyrie, they told the tobacco mosaic virus is a nucleoprotein, which means it's a combination of nucleic acid and protein. And they told that in the 1936. The next one is Watson and Crick discovered the double helical structure of DNA. So DNA contains two helix, which was bonded in a nitrogen base, that is ATGC. So for that, they got Nobel Prize in the year of 1962. So next coming to Geirer and Scram, they showed that nucleic acid is the infection material. So as I already told that a virus contains two components, that is nucleic acid and protein coat. Here nucleic acid is the main infectious material, whereas protein coat only protects the nucleic acid and it has no role in disease spread or disease transmission. So all investigation about double-stranded RNA was also done by Geirer and Scram. Before that, there is no double-stranded RNA virus has been reported. But after Geirer and Scram 1956, they investigated about the double-stranded RNA viruses. The next one is Kohler and Milstein. They developed a hybridoma technology. It is a technology which is used for the production of monoclonal antibodies. And they shared the Nobel Prize for the discovery of hybridoma technology. The next was Wohler, Clark and Adams. They developed the ELISA technique, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. It is a technique which is used for the detection of plant viruses. The next one is Prusiner. So they developed prions in animals. For the discovery of prions, he received Nobel Prize in 1997. Very simple. Prions is a malfunctioned protein. Very simple. It's a malfunctioned protein which already there in the brains of animals. So due to this malfunctioning of this protein, they acts like, you know, that's why it's called a mad cow disease or bovine spongiform encephalopathy. This is due to prions. So the next one is Andrew Fire and Craig Mello. So they discovered a concept of RNA interference. It is otherwise called as PTGS, post-transcriptional gene silencing in the nematode Chenorhabditis elegans. So for the discovery of RNA interference technology, they shared the Nobel Prize in the year of 2006. Here very simple, this RNA interference technology worked like, you know, a translation and transcription process. This, due to the presence of this double-stranded RNA, it simply inhibits the translation process. So if the virus enters into the plant cell, due to this inhibition of translation process, messenger RNA can't be converted into protein. So there is no disease. Yes. Finally, I would like to conclude, the man who studies history can make history. So very important things only I mentioned, that because so many contributions are there, only breakthrough events or breakthrough contributions I put a light onto. Okay, this is for now.